हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एडू नॉलेज हब। दिस इज़ सौम्या दास, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिक्स, बंगाल स्कूल ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सुगंधा, हुगली। एंड टुडे आई हैव कम अप विद द टॉपिक दैट इज़ द हर्बल इंग्रेडिएंट्स यूज्ड इन द हेयर केयर कॉस्मेटिक्स। नाउ आई हैव सिलेक्टेड दिस टॉपिक फ्रॉम द सिलेबस ऑफ एम फार्म सेकेंड ईयर। द सब्जेक्ट इज़ कॉस्मेटिक्स एंड कॉस्मेस्यूटिकल्स। आई फील दैट दिस टॉपिक कैन ऑल्सो बी हेल्पफुल टू अदर फार्मेसी स्टूडेंट्स लाइक बी फार्मेसी एंड डी फार्मेसी टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द डिफरेंट हर्बल इन्ग्रीडियंट्स विच इज़ यूज इन केयरिंग फॉर द हेयर। एंड दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी हेल्पफुल फॉर द अदर पर्सन्स और द पीपल हु आर इंटरेस्टेड टू नो अबाउट द डिफरेंट नेचुरल थिंग्स विच कैन बी यूज ऑन द हेयर टू मेंटेन योर हेयर प्रॉपरली। सो लेट अस बिगिन द वीडियो। Now first we have to understand that what is cosmetics. So coming to the science of cosmetics, all of us know that this is the word which is derived from the Greek word called as the cosmetikos. That means to adorn or to beautify ourselves. Now the main intention of the cosmetics was to adorn, to beautify and to decorate ourselves. This is not a nowadays practice. This practice is since a very long time, and Queen Cleopatra is believed to be the original lady who used the cosmetics regularly and different types of cosmetics. Now coming to the definition of the cosmetics, cosmetics is defined by the Drugs and Cosmetics Act. Previously the cosmetics segment was not included in the DC Act, but gradual amendments brought in the DC Act has included cosmetics in the DC Act. Now coming to the definition as per the DC Act, we can define cosmetics that any article which is intended to be rubbed, poured, sprinkled, sprayed, introduced, applied to any part of the human body for cleansing, for beautifying, for promoting attractiveness or for altering the appearance. So in a nutshell, I can say these cosmetic preparations are mainly meant to maintain the hygienic conditions and to adorn ourselves or to beautify ourselves. Previously, you can say, or you will be very surprised to know that these dentifrices, that means the toothpaste, tooth powders, mouthwashes, they were not included under the cosmetics, but gradually, due course of time, this toothpaste, tooth powders, that means the dentifrices segment, as well as the personal hygiene segment, that is the soap, the scents, these are also included under the cosmetics, which is governed by the DC Act. Now, if you come to the definition of the herbal cosmetics is the birth which is given by the Ayurveda. The practice of Ayurveda is not a new one. India mainly is practicing this Ayurveda since a very long period of time, and the herbal cosmetics, the knowledge of herbal cosmetics is derived generally from this Ayurveda. So if you come to the definition of this herbal cosmetics, we can define any cosmetic preparation which is containing one or more herbal product can be classified as the herbal cosmetics. And the main aim of the cosmetics is to beautify ourselves or to give us an attractive look. Now if you talk about the hair care products, mainly the hair care products which are used by the people, they are mainly meant to maintain your hair. That means to manage your hair, to make your hair look better, or to maintain the property and the behavior of the hair. And this may include a wide range of products starting from your hair conditioners, hair sprays, hair straighteners, hair relaxers, shampoos, rinses, tonic and dressing. So mainly the aim of this hair care product is to give you a better hair, clean hair, or maintain the hygiene of the hair, along with that promoting the attractiveness of the hair also. Now when you are selecting a hair care product, we have to keep some features or some ideal characteristics in my mind. So the first one is the use or the ease to use. Now any hair care product you are selecting, the first option is it should be easily used and easily removed from your hair. The second property which we require is it should have a local effect only. That means I want to make it very clear that any cosmetic preparation which you are using, the main aim is the local activity. There is no cosmetic preparation which is intended to be used inside your body. Like the other dosage forms like your tablet, capsules, parenteral, etc., they are meant to be used inside or sometimes ointments also externally we are using. But these cosmetic preparations are always used to be applied or used on the skin. Now, when you are using any cosmetic preparation, you should be very clear that it should not have any systemic effect, that it should not hamper the physiology of your body. It should be harmless to the hair, skin and the mucous membrane. Mucous membrane means sometimes suppose you are using any shampoo or conditioner and you are washing it. So, there is a risk that it enters inside your eyes or in the nose. So, in that case, it should not be irritant or toxic to the mucous membrane of your eyes or the nose. It should not be allergic to the body. Definitely any kind of cosmetic preparation you are using, it should not have any kind of allergic reactions, and definitely it should be applied topically only. As I told, it should not be applied systemically or inside our body. Now coming to or discussing the why herbal cosmetics. Now this is a very important concept, like since a very long period of time we are into the science of cosmetics, but past 10 years onwards you can see that there is a lot many inventions or lot many research going on in the herbal cosmetics. Now what made it or what is the main goal, why we are so much inclining towards the herbal cosmetics? There are generally five important points. The first one is safe to use. Now it is our thinking, or it is generally the research has proved that maximum herbal cosmetics are safe to use. They don't have any kind of side effects, or if at all they have the side effects, the effects are very very less. They can be treated very easily as compared to the synthetic cosmetic preparations, and they are compatible with all the skin types. Now if you take the example of herbal cosmetics and take the example of the synthetic cosmetics, so this synthetic cosmetics are meant for different skin care or for the different types of hair. But if you take the example of the herbal cosmetics, then the herbal cosmetics can be used for any kind of skin or any kind of hair without any particular care. Wide selection to choose from. There are numerous Ayurvedic products, numerous herbal ingredients which can be incorporated. There is no side effects, as I told you, no or very minimum side effects. And this is also a science coming under the cosmeceuticals. That means cosmeceuticals is a branch of cosmetics which is helping in maintaining the health of the skin and hair or the site where you are applying. Now here I have kept some statistics. You can see the first figure says that the hair care market is 7.6 million USD. That means every year there is a turnover of 7.6 million US dollars, and this turnover is only generated from the different hair care preparations. Now if you see the market outlook here, this market outlook I am talking about, now you can see that this is the market outlook for the herbal cosmetic segments in the year 2017 to 2022. This is a research I have taken it from the research paper, and it states that in 2017 it is 6480 people they used to prefer the herbal cosmetics, but when it comes to 2022 there is a chance of increment or up to 15830. That means more than the double. Now the same thing if you take in the hair care products. Now suppose 3840 people are using the herbal hair care product, in 2022 projected increment will lead to the number that is 7920. That means a growth of 16%. So we can say, dear students, that definitely this herbal cosmetics is having a future and having a market in the coming time. Now let us check in, or let us see that what are the different kind of herbs which we can use in the hair care products. And the first one which everybody of us know, I think, that is the amla. Now amla is belonging to the family of Euphorbiaceae, and the botanical name is Amelica officinalis. It is a deciduous tree which generally grows at the height of 350 meters. We can find this amla everywhere in India. but generally it is cultivated commercially for the purpose of marketing in Uttar Pradesh, Gujarat, Rajasthan and Maharashtra, because the soil of these places they support the growth of this amla. And amla contains the tannins such as the gallic acid, ellagic acid and phylloxylamine. And this is the main reason why this amla is incorporated in maximum of the shampoos and the hair oils. Mainly the aqueous extract is used. Along with the aqueous extract in the hair oils, we can use the oil extract also. And I have kept some marketed formulation of the amla. It's very familiar. You can see this is the Dabur Amla hair oil, which is very familiar to us since a very long period of time. Now the second ingredient is the Brahmi. The botanical name of Brahmi is Centella asiatica, and this is belonging to the family Umbelliferae. Now this Brahmi is generally seen in as a creeping herb. That means it is a creeper which grows in the bank of the rivers, because the wet soil near the bank of the river supports the growth of the Brahmi. It generally occurs in the marshy places where the sunlight is less and the soil is very damp or the wet. Generally in the northern part of the India, it contains many kinds of oils, sterols, flavonols, glycoside, triterpenoids and saponins. And Brahmi oil is mainly preferred, which is obtained from the soft extract, which can be incorporated in different kind of the hair care product. Now Brahmi is one of the important, you can say, Ayurvedic ingredient for many preparations. In case of the hair care, it is used for delaying the aging. Like if you are using a Brahmi oil, the aging of your hair, that means the graying of the hair will be decreased. And sometimes Brahmi also helps in relieving the fatigue. If you massage the Brahmi oil into your scalp, then it is meant to have some relaxing effect on your scalp also. Now I have kept here the example, the marketed formulation of Brahmi, that is the Bajaj Brahmi Amla oil. Now coming to the third one, that is the Bhringraj. Now Bhringraj, that is coming from the family Asteraceae, and the botanical name says Eucalypta alba Linn. Now this Linn, why we have added is because we have different grades of Bhringraj. Here the Bhringraj alba is used. It is an annual or perennial plant. That means it comes up annually or perennial. It dies with the course of time, which is again found in the most moist parts of the India in some ascending heights, like up to 6,600 feet it can be seen. And there are different kind of products which is present in the Brahmi, like alkaloids are there, glycosides are there, triterpene acids are there and steroids are there. And Brahmi is a very good hair tonic actually, which maintains the healthy hair. Like it prevents from hair fall, and the black and long hair can be maintained by using this Bhringraj. Now Bhringraj is having one unique property, that if you are using this Bhringraj oil, then the breakage of the hair is also reduced. Here is one of the example of the marketed preparation of Bhringraj oil, that is the Morpheum company has Bhringraj oil, which is made by the pure cold pressed oil. That means the oil is extracted by the cold press technique. The next one is the coconut, very familiar to us. Coconut coming from the family Palmae. The botanical name says Coccus nucifera, and coconut trees can be seen everywhere in India, but generally it is seen in the seaside. That means the salty air is helpful for growth of this coconut. And this coconut oil generally it is used in the formulation like shampoos and the hair oils, because coconut has a very good saponification value. That means it is easily used to saponify the shampoos and oils. So coconut oil is used in maximum of the shampoos as the emulsifying agent. Now coming to the eucalyptus. Eucalyptus belongs to the family Myrtaceae, and the name says Eucalyptus globulus. That is the botanical name. It is a very height. The tree has a very long height, and it is cultivated all over the India for the production of the oil. Along with the hair care, this eucalyptus has its property in also in some type of the you can say ingredients which is used or cosmetic or any kind of the medicinal agent which is used in relieving the cold or the sneezing. And it contains mainly the volatile aldehydes, terpenes, alcohols and the phenols. And the oil is colorless to slightly yellow in color, which has a very characteristic odor. That means by the smell of the eucalyptus oil, you can identify that it belongs to the eucalyptus. It is spicy, and if you taste it, it has a very cooling sensation to your mouth. Generally, eucalyptus is used on the dandruff scalp. That means for the treatment of the dandruff or a disease called as a scurf. Next is the henna, the Lausenia inermis. It belongs to the family Lythraceae, and henna finds its importance in the hair coloring. It is mainly cultivated and it grows widely in the garden also. It is a garden plant. This the henna leaves are mainly taken for the extraction of the herbal ingredients. It contains the lauson, which is the quinone, and this lauson it dissolves in a basic pH to give it dark intense orange coloration. Now when this henna is applied on the hair, it interacts with your keratin and gives the coloration to your hair also. Now this has been used, or this has been used since a very long period of time. In very ancient ages also we are using this henna for the hair dyes, for coloring the hair. Now the next is the neem. The neem belongs to the family Meliaceae. The botanical name says Argyrtica indica. And this neem is indigenous to India, because India is the only country which has more cultivation of the neem. It is originally belonging to India also. It is mainly seen in the sub-Himalayan tracts with the altitude ranging from 700 to 10,000 meters above the sea level. The neem leaf contains different kind of products like flavonoids, steroids, terpenoids, sterols, nimbolid. Now this neem leaf and the neem seed, generally the neem leaf, the neem seed oil, it contains bitter limonoids including the nimbimin and the saline, etc. Neem, it has its importance or use in the control of the ticks, leeks and the lice. That means the things or the organisms which resides in the hair. And this can also find its use in some of the herbal hair oils, hair tonic and the conditioners also. Neem, generally neem is used for the prophylactic treatment for the prevention from the lice or any kind of the organism which grows on your hair. Next is the gudhal, or we can say the hibiscus. Now the hibiscus belongs to the family Malvaceae. The botanical name says Rosa sinensis. It is an Indian garden plant and it is also cultivated. It contains different kinds of substances like taraxeryl acetate, beta sitosterol, campesterol, sigma sterol, cholesterol also, ergosterol, flavonoids, glycosides, lipids, citric and oxalic acids. Now this hibiscus petals, it is believed to stimulate your hair growth or the thicker hair, and it also prevents a premature graying of your hair and the scalp disorders. Scalp disorder means chapping of the skin or from the dandruff. Now the petal extract, the petal when dissolved in the water, it gets the extract, and this extract can be natural hair conditioners and it can be also used as the hair washes. Next is Jetamansi. Jetamansi belong to the family Valerianaceae. The botanical name says Nardustatus jetamansi. It is grown widely in India, generally in the northern India and the east India, and it is mainly found in the alpine Himalayas and the altitude of 3000 to 5000. The rhizomes of Jetamansi is considered, they are pale yellow. It gives a pale yellow volatile oil. And this jetamansic acid and ketones are the main reason why we are using this jetamansi. The rhizomes gives the oil, and these rhizomes find it application in the hair tonic preparation to promote the growth of the hair and impart the blackness, that means maintenance of the black color of the hair. And the hair growth which is due to this jetamansi is basically for the jetamansic acid which is present in this rhizomes of the jetamansi. Next is the fenugreek. This fenugreek comes from the family Leguminaceae. The botanical name is the Trigonella Phoenogracium, and this fenugreek is a leguminous herb which heights up to 2 feet. It is cultivated, or it can be grown. Now this is having, or it is a cover crop in the citrus fruit groves. That means along with the cultivation of the citrus fruit like orange and lemons, we grow the fenugreek so that the legumes or the legumes which are present in the roots, it will be controlling the nitrogen in the soil. And it is mainly cultivated in the areas like Rajasthan, Gujarat, Uttar Pradesh and the Tamil Nadu. The alkaloids which is present in the fenugreek are responsible for different kind of hair care. Like if you apply the paste of the leaves, then it can promote the hair growth, preserves the natural color and maintains the silkiness of the hair. Sometimes fenugreek is also believed to control the dandruff also. Next is the cedarwood oil. Now cedarwood oil is derived from the plant that is Juniperus virginiana, and this cedarwood oil, it is extracted mainly from the cedar, that is the fruit which is available. It contains different kind of essential oils like alpha cedrine, beta cedrine, cedrol, vidrol, etc. Some sesquiterpenes are also present which also contribute to the medicinal values. It is mainly used for the dry hair. The people who have the dry hair tendency, we can use it to induce the hair growths. This oil can be massaged on the scalp. The next ingredient is the shikakai, which comes from the family Mimosaceae, and the botanical name is Acacia consitzna. And this shikakai is used widely, and it's a very old use. Like we have been using the shikakai from a very long period of time. It is a shrub and it is generally seen in the central and the south India. This shikakai, the name says the fruits for hair, shikakai, the name says the fruits for the hair or the fruits of the hair. That means this fruits is mainly meant for the hair, and this has the excellent cleansing and the astringent property. That means it can be used as a conditioner. After washing your hair with the shampoo, if you are using the shikakai, then this can be used as a detangler or as a conditioner to your hair. We can add the shikakai to the hair washes. It can promote the hair growth, remove the dandruff and also strengthen the hair. The next one is the almond oil, which is extracted from the fruits of the Prunus dulcis, which belongs to the family Rosaceae. It is obtained from the ripe fruits. As I see, the ripe fruits have the ripe seeds, and the oil is extracted from the cold expression technique. It is cultivated commercially in the north side of India, which has 40 to 55% of the fixed oils and high protein quantity. Now this fixed oil mainly contains the oleic acid, the linoleic acid and the palmitic acid. Commercially, this almond oil can be incorporated in some dermatological product, which can be used as a hair tonic and the hair lotions. The next one is the sesame oil, which belongs to the family of Pedaliaceae. The sesame oil is extracted from the seeds of the sesame indicum, and this is mainly extracted from the ripe seeds, which is an annual herb, which grows as an annual herb. It is commercially cultivated in Gujarat, West Bengal, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab and Karnataka. These sesame seeds, they contain the sesame oil, and the sesame oil contains a palmitic acid, oleic acid, linoleic acid, stearic acid, arachidonic acid, behenic acid, gandrolic acid, etc. And mainly they are used for the hair tonic formulations. Next is the jojoba oil. Now this jojoba oil comes from the seeds of jojoba, which belongs to the family Simondiaceae, and the botanical name is Simonsa chinensis. And this oil is extracted from the seeds of this plant by the cold press method. Jojoba plant is cultivated commercially in Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, and this contains some eicosanoic acids, docosanoic acid, oleic acid. Mainly this oil is used as a revitalizing agent for the hair growth. Means if you don't have the hair growth, so this can be massaged on your scalp to promote the hair growth. Next is the arnica. Now this arnica is also a plant having different medicinal value. This belongs to the family of Apiaceae and the botanical name is Arnica montana. It is obtained from the dried roots and flowers of the Arnica montana. Arnica is a yellow color flower which is beautiful looking, and it is cultivated as a perennial herb in northern region of India. Arnica contains arnesin, different volatile oils, tannins and fullin. Arnica oil can be incorporated in the hair tonics and the anti-dandruff preparations. Now dear students, I come to the end of this topic, that is the herbal ingredients used in the hair care preparation. I have collected this material from these published articles and some of the books. So here the ingredients which I have mentioned is limited, that means I have mentioned only 16 ingredients. Apart from this, you can find many more ingredients which can also be used in the hair care cosmetics. Now if you have any kind of doubt or if you have any kind of questions or queries, you can drop me a mail to the mail ID mentioned here, that is soumyaranidas@gmail.com or edunowledgehub@gmail.com. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, that is the Edu Knowledge Hub, for more videos. I will be coming up with the more videos in the due course of time. Till then, I hope that everybody stays safe and fine. Have a nice day. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.